Now we're going to go ahead and move into page layout. Just as we started out rough with designing our character and designing our story, we're going to want to start out with a rough design of our page. This leaves you free to make any of your mistakes and get them out of the way before you finally start putting down ink. So, the best way to do that is to start out with something that I like to call thumbnailing. And you may have heard that term before, but it basically means just making a rough sketch, rough layout of what you're going to do. I like to go ahead and just lay out the shape of my page so I know what format I'm working in. I like to work kind of a traditional comics 11 by 17, and I get that set up, and then I start figuring out where my panels are going to go on the page. The panels are the most important part of laying out a page of comics, so do not brush over this. Do not leave anything to chance. These panels are going to help communicate the pace of your story, and they're going to help keep things clear for your reader so they can follow along. I like to stay with a pretty basic panel layout. I know there's tons of fancy stuff that you can get into, but especially if you're just starting out, it often helps to keep things pretty basic. You don't have to have crazy shaped panels or things busting the panel board or whatever. That can get really confusing, especially if you're not familiar with using it. So try and keep things pretty simple, pretty clear, at least when you start out. The more confidence you get with it, the more you can go ahead and move on. I'm going to show you two different ways to create a panel border quickly and easily. The first one is to use this box ruler. Go down here and select this icon and make sure it's the rectangle. And then go ahead and find the brush size, and you can set it to whatever you want. I have it set to about 19, which is going to look like this. I don't like to have my panel borders be too big and chunky, but again, it's your preference. So what you do is you click and hold and pull it out until it's about the size that you want, and then let go. And it will autofill with whatever the foreground color is. So if you want black, use black. I like red, so I'm using red. Now, the other way to do that is to take any brush tool whatsoever. I'm going to use the pencil. You click at a point, hold down the shift key, and pull down the line until it is straight, and then you let go. And you just do that until you have drawn your entire panel, like so. And just kind of look at the edges of the lines there. You can see when it finally lines up what it kind of ends up looking like. Now, since that's the way I normally like to do it, I'm going to go ahead and use that technique to finish off this page. Try and think about your gutters, which are the spaces between your panels, and keep them even and straight if you can. It helps to give your page a nice professional look. When you're designing your panels, you're going to want to go ahead and try and think about how the eye is going to move around not only the page, but also your panel in general. Keep pretty clear, simple compositions. Try and keep your motion flowing in the direction that you want the reader's eye to move. All right, and there's your page with all of your panel borders already set up. So now that we have our panel borders, we're going to want to talk about thumbnailing. I'm going to go ahead and pull up a page that I've already done that has a very similar layout to this, so you can have a look at what thumbnailing looks like. All right, so here you can see I have two separate layers. The top layer is my rough artwork, and the bottom layer is my panel layout. It looks pretty similar to the thing I just laid out on the other file. I like to keep my artwork separate from the panels in case I have to go back in and erase something. I don't end up taking out my panel borders while I'm redrawing somebody's face. As you can see, the artwork here is really rough, and that's kind of the point of thumbnailing. Really, you're doing this so you can figure out how everything is going to fit in each of your panels. Also, try and at this stage, think about lettering. We're not going to talk about lettering for a while, but it's really important when you're laying things out to leave enough room for all the stuff that you're going to want to do, and lettering is a big part of that. Nobody wants to try and cram lettering balloons into a panel that's overcrowded with characters, so please do think about keeping space traditionally at the top of the panel for all of your balloons to go later, and I don't accidentally draw too much background that's just going to get covered up or put a character's head in the way of a giant balloon where they're going to need to be talking a lot. In this page, the two characters are having a conversation. You'll notice that I have left room at the top of the panels for their word balloons to go. So while you're filling your panels up with thumbnails, you're going to want to think about what you want to go in each panel and how it's going to be laid out. It's more interesting to the reader's eye if you pick a wide variety of panel compositions. For instance, these three are pretty similar, and they're about mid-shots, but then I've gotten a close-up on the two characters holding their hands together, and I've got a long shot here where we pull back to see that they're sitting on something here, and you can see both of them in full body. I've also got a close-up where you can see a mid-shot of one character and then a super zoomed-in shot of the arm of another character. It helps to keep it interesting, and that way your reader won't get bored, and it gives you new and interesting ways to communicate the points in your panels. I've also kept it incredibly rough, and that's totally fine, because right now you're going to make decisions. You're going to be trying out and seeing what works and what doesn't. If it's a rough drawing, you're more likely to want to erase it than if you spent 20 minutes making the most perfect character ever. Once you're done laying out all of your rough panels with all of your rough pictures inside, you're going to want to clean it up. Now for me, since I've been drawing this comic for a while, I'm pretty comfortable knowing what I want to do when I clean things up, so I tend to jump straight from thumbnails into my inks. But for you, if you're just starting out and you're not really sure that you're comfortable going over something this rough and making it look clean and beautiful, you might want to go to the penciling stage like we talked about in character design, where you lay down those final lines in pencil before you commit to anything with ink. This is where you're going to make your scribbles something that actually reads. Go through, clean up your character. If the eye is wonky, fix it. If the perspective is wonky, fix it now. That way when you go to inks, you don't have to think about it. I like to just make sure that I have everything as tight as possible so that when I'm going to inks and laying down brushstrokes, I'm not freaking out going, oh, did I really want that here? Did I really want that here? Go ahead and make your final decisions. Once you finish cleaning things up with your pencils, you're going to want to go ahead and move on to inks. Inking is where you're going to solidify everything. So if anything's still looking a little bit wonky, a little bit muddy, hopefully you cleaned it up in the pencils, but if not, inking is your chance to go ahead and take care of that. All right, I'm going to go ahead and start inking this page. So the way I like to start, I'm going to combine the two files using Ctrl-E so that my thumbnails are now one layer. And then I'm going to lighten that just a little bit so that I can still kind of see the hint of it, but that it's not too distracting. Then I'm going to create two more layers on top of that. One is going to be for my final inked panels, and the other is going to be for the final inked artwork. Now, you can start with whatever panel you want. Oftentimes, I like to start with the panel that seems the simplest or that has something that looks like it might be fun to do so I can kind of warm up my hand and build my confidence before moving on to a more complicated part of the page. So for me, that would be this panel here on the right. Now let's go ahead and grab our pen and set it to the color of ink that we want to use. I'm going to go ahead and use black. And my brush is too thick, so I'm going to use the bracket key to turn down my brush size just a little bit until it is the size that I want to have for my panel borders. And again, I'm going to use that same trick where you start at one point, hold down the shift key, and drag out your line. Do this until you've completed your panel. There you go. The panel is ready to go. Now let's move to our other blank layer and start creating our artwork. Adjust my brush size until it's something I'm comfortable with, and maybe zoom in just a little bit so I can see things just a little bit better. You don't want to zoom in too much and get too noodly, otherwise you're going to end up wasting a lot of time drawing in a lot of detail that no one's even. Just a little bit is totally okay. If your brush size isn't where you want it, just go ahead and adjust it until it's right, and then start. As you can see, sometimes inking can be pretty time consuming, so for the sake of time, I have another example of this page that I've already inked to completion. You can see my thumbnails underneath my inks, and you can tell that I've sometimes changed my mind while I was inking of where I wanted things to go. As you become more confident, this is something that you'll probably end up doing quite a bit. Sometimes what you come up with in your thumbnails looks great in thumbnails, but once you start inking, your hand and your brain decide to do something else entirely, and that's totally okay. You'll get a feel for it as your skill and confidence level grows. So now that we've set up our page layout with our thumbnails, and then gone through and cleaned it up with pencils and finalized everything with inks, it's time to move into the coloring stage.